I've always had a love for quotes, be them long or short, in English or not. There's something special about a few chosen words put together in a phrase that sums up a big idea or piece of advice. We've heard a lot of them over the last few years, I'm sure. Latin phrases are of particular interest to me. The language, as the foundation of ours, seems fitting that most of the proverbs and short sayings that we hear originate in Latin. The phrase I want to bring before you today, this day that we celebrate our hard work of the last few years, this day that marks the end of one chapter of our lives, and this day that marks the beginning of another very exciting and challenging chapter of our lives, is Destitus Ventus Remis Ad Hyc. If the wind will not serve, take to the oars. We're in this ocean called life, if you will, and there's an endless amount of possibilities, endless directions we can go, things we can see and experience, and stops along the way. Once in a while, a breeze comes. It fills our sails and takes us places we never thought we'd go. Other times, it seems we sit in the middle of nowhere, and we have a choice to make. We can either sit and not move, wait, see if a breeze will come and take us somewhere, or we can take to the oars. We can move and strive and steer our lives where we want to go. And every one of us today has done that. We decided to go to college. Some of you may have rowed all the way here. You knew where you were going. Others of us were rowing towards the broad college horizon. A breeze came and suddenly we found ourselves in Plainview, Texas. And then each of us decided what course our studies would take. We decided on a major. It may have changed a few times. You may have realized the direction you were rowing wasn't really where you wanted to go, so you changed directions. And this, I believe, is the beautiful thing about life, is we make decisions, and each of those choices takes us somewhere. But as you know, it's not so much about the destination as it is about the journey and what you learn along the way. Each of us has learned something in the last few years, we hope. Beyond the facts, the numbers, the equations, we've learned other things that aren't quite as measurable. For instance, as freshmen, we may have learned that although parking under a tree on a hot fall day seemed like a good idea, you soon discovered that although you may have when you were five, you never really want a white polka dot car. And unlike some of our poor out-of-town friends and family are discovering, we know these roads. We know the hidden potholes and the lumps and the bumps that when you hit them just right will rattle your teeth and spill your brew coffee all over your lap. But we've learned. We've learned how to survive. We've learned what we had to do to make it here today and to graduate today. We knew exactly how little we could do and pass. We probably all got pretty good at that. We knew exactly what we had to do to find success as well, and hopefully we all got practice at that as well. But these are the lessons that we should take with us into our careers. Very few of us will have to solve for X in a complicated equation, some will, or know the date that someone important died. That's why we have the internet today. But every one of us will have to decide on a daily basis if we will do just enough to get by or if we will go above and beyond to find success in our careers and in life. So these are some of the things that college taught us without teaching us. Things we picked up along the way that we may have never realized we were learning until we used them later on. That's because when you take to the oars, when you work towards a goal, you learn so much about life and about yourself along the way. So whatever direction we steer from here, even if we change our minds or are taken in a completely unforeseen direction, let's remember that we'll learn from it and we'll be better because of the journey. Hard work pays off. We are evidence of that today. So, my friends, fellow graduates of 2015 from Wayland Baptist University, let's take to the oars. Let's work. Let's strive for our goals and direct our own lives and benefit the world around us. Sure, the wind is going to catch us sometimes and help us or take us in a completely new direction. But whatever happens, let's never stop striving. Let's never stop trusting our Lord because we've been trained and we've been equipped. And now it's our time to take to the